Welcome, dear students, to lecture 1 of module 2, block diagrams and signal flow graphs of the subject control systems. So in this lecture we'll be learning the basics about the block diagrams. What are the rules we have to follow to solve a block diagram to find the transfer function? So what is a block diagram? A block diagram of a system is a pictorial representation of the functions performed by each component and of the flow of signals. It depicts the interrelationship that exists among the various components. In a block diagram, all system variables are linked to each other through the blocks. The functional block or simply block is a symbol for the mathematical operation on the input signal to the block that produces the output. So let us see what are the components that are there in the block diagram. So one is the block. It indicates the function of a particular system. R of s is a reference or the controlling variable. G of s is a transfer function of the particular system. C of s is the output or a control variable. And in the feedback, we normally denote it as H of s. So here we have the summing point, or we can also call it as a summation point. So summation point has more than two or more than two inputs. So R of s is one input over here. So maybe I can take it as y or x. It can be given as plus or minus. Here it is plus. So accordingly, it will add or subtract depending on the polarities what we have over here. So this is a summation or summing point. Next is a takeoff point. Takeoff point is from where the signal is taken and fed to somewhere else. So this is the takeoff point what you observe over here. Okay, these are the three things. So block, summation point and the takeoff point. Now next, this is a block diagram of a closed loop system. So let us find the transfer function of the block diagram here. So first I will write what is E of s. See here, E of s is error signal. Again, see, you have a summation point over here. Then we have the different blocks. This whatever you see over, this is the takeoff point. Okay, so what is E of s? So E of s is R of s minus H of s. So this is a negative feedback system. If you have a negative here, it is a negative feedback system. If it is a positive, it will be a positive feedback system. So now I will work out for the negative feedback. Later on, I will give you the expression for the positive feedback system as well as that. So here it is H of s into C of s. We know at this point, right, this is a takeoff point. So to takeoff point, we get the signal C of s multiplied by H of s. So here it comes. At this point, it will be H of s into C of, yes, so I can write it as E of s, R of s minus H of s, C of s. Next, I will write what is C of s. So, what is C of s here? When I observe over here, this C of s, it is E of s into G of s. So, let me write it E of s into G of s. E of s already we have got here above, so I'll just substitute it over here. So, R of s minus C of s into H of s into G of s. Now I can take C of s to the left hand side. So if I take it to the left hand side, I get it as 1. This minus will become plus G of s into H of s, which is equal to R of s into G of s. So what is C of s by R of s? So C of s by R of s equal to G of s divided by 1 plus G of s H of s. So this is the transfer function. Now this is for a positive negative feedback transform. We get it plus. If we have a negative feedback, then this is the transfer function. Okay. So negative feedback, it is G of s by 1 plus G of s H of s. If we have a positive feedback, then we have G of s by 1 minus G of s H of s. This is the only difference. Okay. So this is the how to solve a, or what is the transfer function of a closed loop system. Next, let us see some rules what you are supposed to follow when we are doing this block diagram reduction. Now, if we have a block diagram reduction over here, we have a block diagram, different blocks, okay, different arrangements. So first thing what you have to see is we have to see whether we have any blocks in series. Second thing is see if there are any blocks in parallel. First solve it. Then see if there are any feedback loops. If there are no loops, then we'll have to do some shifting of summation point or takeoff point and then proceed with again the same procedure has to be followed to finally get the transfer function. So the rules we have to see to solve this block diagram. So first rule is, in case if two blocks are connected in series, then what is the answer? Now here G1 and G2, see they are in cascade or series, then what we get? We simply multiply it, so we get G1, G2 and G3. Now say I connect three blocks G1, then G2, then say G3 over here. Then finally, what all these three are in series, so I can write all together, just multiply it, G1, G2, G3. So this will be the final answer of this if they are connected in series. Next rule, we'll see if the blocks are in parallel, then the blocks have to be added or subtracted depending on the summing point signal. So in this case, see, G1 and G2 are given. So here plus or minus is given. So G1 I have only positive over G1, and here G2 plus or minus. So we have to check the signs here of two, which block has what sign now. So G1 has plus, so G1 will come in the beginning. And plus or minus, depending whether it is plus, it will become plus. If it is minus, then it will become minus. So it will be G1 plus or minus G2. This is rule 2 if the blocks are connected in parallel. Next rule is moving the takeoff point after the block. Now here, see here, takeoff point after the block, it is given signal. This U is a signal here and G. What I will do is, now without moving it, I will write over it, see. I'll simply move the block, then I will come to know why this 1 by G is needed here. CG, I have simply moved the block now. We have moved the takeoff point, okay, after the block. So here U, right, here, from here, what is the signal here? This is Y, right? I get the signal here, G into U. So here also I get G into U. But what is the initial signal, what was supposed to, we had to take it or take it back. It was only U. But now extra G is there. If I have to remove this G, I'll have to divide it by N G, right? So that is why what we do, if we have to do this, and if there should not be any, whatever shifting you do, it should not affect the block diagram. So we have to do 1 by G. See over here. Now you see, you have U over here and we have G into U. By the time it comes over here, see what happens. Again, we have G into U by G. So, we get U only. So, finally, initially, whatever my diagram was here, block diagram was here, I get the same thing over here. That is why we have to have a 1 by G in the feedback path when we are doing this shifting of takeoff point after the block. I hope you have understood why this 1 by G is included over here. Now next we will see moving the takeoff point before the block. The same thing I will do. Now I will just simply shift it before the block. See G. It was here. I will shift it here. See here. This, see what was the signal here? It was G into U. So this also we got as G into U. Now here what happens? This is U. So I simply get a U over here. But actually, what is the signal I am supposed to have? G into U, which I don't get over here, right? I need a G along with this U. So what we have to do? So we actually see G over here and here, this one, right? From here, if I take, I need a G into U as a signal. So what I'll do? I'll simply connect a block G. So if I have a U over here and if it comes over, then I get a G into U. So, whatever initially, whatever signal I got over here, no, the same signal will be here also even after the shifting is done. That is why we have to include a G in the feedback path. So, this is why we have to do this. Now, next one more rule is moving summing point after the block. So, let me apply the same thing. So, see here, this is the original one. After the movement, this is what you are supposed to have. Why this G is needed, I will show you here. So, see here. Now we will have moved it. Say I'll simply move it over here. G. Summing point is here. Okay. And this was U2, right? This was U1. Initially here, the initial, what we had here, it was U1 minus U2. So after this, here at this final point, Y will be G into U1 minus U2. Okay. Now here, let me consider here now. So at this point, I get this as U1 into G. And this is a minus if I take. At here, this Y will be U1G minus U2. But what was I supposed to have? I was supposed to have it as GU1 minus GU2. But I'm not getting it here, right? U2 is only U2. So what I'll have to do here, I will just redraw it again. See. So G, and I have moved it. And here, if I include a G along with U2, this minus, and here we have U1. What do we get here at Y? Y is equal to C. This, at this point, we get U1 into G. At this point, we get U2 into G. So what do we get here? U1 G1 minus U2 G. So initially, whatever the signals was at Y, the same thing will be there even after the shifting. That is why you will have to add one G block in the path over here with the other summation, which comes to the summation point. This is what you're supposed to do when if you're moving it after the block. Then this is the last rule, that is moving the summing point ahead of or before the block. So what do we do? See, before the block, I'll simply shift. No, first we will write here what is Y. What do you get Y as? Yes, at this point you have U1 G. And at this point you have simply U2. So we get it as U1G minus U2, right? Now let me just shift it, simply shift it. So summation point. Then we have the G1. And it is like this. Some U2 over here and U1. So at this point this is minus. At this point we have U1 minus U2. So here, what do we get Y as? Y we get as G1 into U1 minus U2, correct? But what are we supposed to actually have the signal as? Its signal is supposed to be U1G minus U2, correct? But here what is happening? We have GU1 minus GU2, which with along with U2, I don't want G, okay? G1 I've considered here, okay, G. Consider it as G. So I don't want G over here. So what do? We have to remove that G. How do we remove? So I'll just again redraw the block over here. So this is G and this is Y. Shifting is done, right? So what do? I simply put a 1 by G. This is U2. So when I come this at this in point, it is U2 by G. And at this point, it is U1. So here it will become U1 minus U2, sorry, U2 by G. So here what happens? Y will be equal to U1G minus U2 by G into G. So GG cancels. What do we get? So we get Y is equal to U1G minus U2. So now it is the same as the initially whatever we had, U1G minus U2. So even after the shifting, the same thing will remain. This is how you have to work out the, or you have to do the, these are the rules you are supposed to follow when you are solving the block diagram. Let us just go through the steps what you are supposed to follow to reduce a block diagram. So first thing is check if there are any series blocks, reduce those series blocks. Then check if there are parallel blocks, you reduce those parallel blocks. Third, check if there are minor feedback loops. If there are minor feedback loops, then you know the formula. Check if it is positive feedback or negative feedback, accordingly apply the formulas. If there are no such, these three things are also not there, then what you do, you see that if you need to shift the summation point or you need to shift the takeoff point, and once you do this, follow the rules, then again do this checking, series, parallel, feedback. Okay, so you have to repeat all these steps until a canonical form is obtained or you get the final transfer function.